We're between Purim and Pesach now. And this week, aside from the regular Parsha, we have Parshas Purah. In the days of the Beis HaMikdash, this is the time that the nation was in preparation for the bringing of the Korban Pesach. And in preparation, there was a necessity for everyone to purify themselves from tumah, from impurity. Parah is dealing with tumas meis. Anyone who in any way came in contact with the body of a deceased, the rules are endless. As a purify himself with the ashes of the red heifer, whole ritual that had to be done set on specific days. So before Pesach, when the whole nation was getting ready for it, they had to learn the rules. Now, the Pesach sacrifice is something that we haven't had because there's no Beis HaMikdash. And this aspect of purity, Tumah V'Taharah, that too is long gone. We have no Parah Adumah, we have no Ephrah Parah, we don't have the ability to purify ourselves from this Tumas Meis. So this is not something we live day in, day out. Yet, Chazal found it important that we remember every year before Pesach what it was like and what it should be like and what it will be one day like when the whole nation will come to Yerushalayim, have a Korban Pesach, and in order to do so, everyone will purify themselves. Today, relating to sacrifices altogether sounds like something of ancient civilization. Smells of witchcraft or pagan rituals. And ritual purity. What's that? Chazal saw it as important that the Jew not think that this is a thing of the past, but something that we yearn for. Now the Korban Pesach, although it was blood that was put aside of the altar, primarily eaten. And that was the end of the Pesach Seder. This is a special kind of sacrifice. Of this, another sacrifice is like it. The Gemara uses the term Mishulchan Gavoa Kazachu, something like having dinner with Hashem. It was brought as a sacrifice, it's his. And he's treating us to it. This is a whole different level of life. Something that seems far away from us. Ritual purity. Becoming sensitive to existence, an existence that we have absolutely no way of being able to feel. None of our five senses will be able to tell us. Just again, it sounds archaic. Whereas in truth, there is a reality to it. We're just so insensitive and out of touch. While we do not fully grasp what it's all about, there's a very important concept that we must learn to relate to. And that is that by way of understanding Torah, we become sensitive to so many different subtleties in life. There are so many realities that most human beings are totally oblivious to. Let's talk simple stuff. Tara Talashon. A purity in the way one speaks. You know, you spend time in yeshiva and people don't speak Lashon Hara. You don't walk around knocking others. You learn to be sensitive. Focusing on qualities rather than faults. People are not expressing negativity about one another. And then you get back out there in the big world, and people freely, it's the most natural topic for conversation. What this one did and how this one failed. How foolish the other one is. It's family, it's friends, it's enemies, it's everybody. If you develop the sensitivity, you feel so out of place. You feel so uncomfortable. What's with everybody out there? When you tell them, they don't know what you're talking about. But it's true. What are we supposed to be, naive fools, thinking everyone's wonderful? along with all the other wisdom of Torah, is a whole level of sensitivity to subtleties in life that others are totally unaware of.